other than that, I think the only stuff I haven't showed yet is the EQ. And the EQ is basically pretty simple. So the EQ is what you use to control the frequencies of music. So you have, it's basically, they divide the song up into three sections: the highs, the mids, and the lows. Now the EQ, when you use the EQ, you're going to use it for a few different purposes. The first purpose, you're going to use the highs for basically trimming them. You're usually going to trim the highs. And what happens is, when you play music really loud, the highs are going to sound very, they're going to hurt your ears. They're going to sound very harsh. So you're going to want to basically turn the highs down a little bit so that it doesn't hurt people's ears as much. And so that's why you'd use this high EQ. So if I were to do this high EQ, so it's going to sound very muffled if I do it all the way, but if I do it slightly, it's just going to trim the highs a little bit. So the mids, you don't really use the mids. So what we did is actually we took the mids and we mapped it to the high and low pass filter, which lets you basically cut out all the high frequencies or cut out all the low frequencies. So I'm going to show you that right now. So this is the high pass. So see how you can hear the beat still, but you can't really hear the highs because it's all cut out. And I can go vice versa. I can cut out all the low stuff. So now you can only hear the really high stuff, and you can do this sort of in between. So one way that you can use this is to make announcements. Like right now you can hear me, but you can also hear the beat of the song. So if you want to make an announcement during a song, to hype people up or just say something, this is a great way to make an announcement without having to stop the song or lower the volume even. Because when you lower the volume, you're also lowering the volume of the microphone. But essentially, this is a great way to make announcements without changing much. Alright. So now you have the lows. And the lows are just basically, usually with beat matching, you'll use this with beat matching to kind of cut the low frequencies. So if you have two songs with really heavy bass lines, they're going to sound muddy, which just means it just sounds like a mess, basically, when you mix them together. So what you'll do is you'll cut the song out, use the low to cut the bass out of the song you're mixing into, and then when you mix it in, you're gonna slowly bring it up and you'll fade out the other song. Now I won't show you that now because it's kind of an abstract concept, but that's essentially why you use the lows. You also might wanna push it a little bit if you wanna have a little bit extra bass boost, but not all the way, because it just sounds horrible. If you do, it just sounds like, it just doesn't really, if your speaker doesn't have bass, it doesn't really do anything anyway. But anyways, so that's why you'd use the lows. And everything else, I showed you the browse knob, I showed you the load buttons, I showed you the mix, the monitoring stuff for monitoring with the headphones, I showed you the EQs, I showed you the channel faders here, I showed you the tempo faders. Now I gotta show you the sync button. So what sync does, it is with beat matching, it essentially makes it automated. And I wouldn't recommend doing this because it you lose some of your control, basically. But what it will do is it'll essentially automate the beat matching process. So if I were to, I could essentially, if I know what I'm doing, I could use sync to beat match. And I'll show you that beat match I just did last time. So I'm gonna do it right here. So I'm gonna go back to my first cue point in Sweet Nothing, and I'm gonna play my other song, Boy Oh Boy. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just set the BPM back to here. So this is 128, the other song is 130, 130, 128. I'm going to use sync to beat match these. And what sync will do is it'll line up the BPMs, and then it will also line up the just beats in general. And it does that all automatically. And I also lose a bit of control, but if you do it correctly, you can use it to your advantage. So I'm gonna set this right here. I need to know exactly where I'm gonna start from. I'm gonna play this other song and press play. So see, they're a little bit out of sync. They're getting a little bit out of sync, but I press sync and it's gonna line them up perfectly. So again, not the best example of beat matching, but essentially that's what sync does, is it lines up the BPMs and it lines up the beats themselves, all automatically. Other than that, I think I just have effects to show you. Effects are pretty easy too. So I'm gonna use this, I'm gonna use a different song because you're probably sick of listening to this song. I'm going to use a good song. Let's see, We Found Love. Sure, I'll play this song. So We Found Love. So up here I have my three effects. I can click this little extended view and see what my effects are that I have loaded up. So I have So the three effects that I've loaded up right now are Echo, Reverb, and Gate. And I can choose these different effects from here. Again, a lot of these are kind of weird. I usually would only use Effect. But if you want to use some other ones, like if I were to change this to Reverb, I'll show you what they are. So, in order to use your effect, you're going to press Effects. As you can see, it's going to have a little echo effect. Let's say I want to make it echo more. I'm going to turn the jog wheel here. And by turning the jog wheel, I'm going to adjust the intensity of the effect. So let's say I want to do effect 2. Same thing. So you can also have multiple effects at once. So if you want to have effect 1 and effect 2 at the same time. And it's just going to pair them together, and then you can adjust the intensity when they're together. You can't do it separately, sadly. But anyways, that is how you use effects. If you hold down shift, you can change the effect, as you see. I'm holding down shift and pressing the button. It's just going to scroll through all your effects that you have available. So that is how you use effects on the DJ controller. So that's basically it. I've showed you how to use effects, how to use the jog wheels to search through a song, how to play a song, how to set hot cues, how to use sync, how to use the shift button, and adjust the tempo using the tempo sliders, adjust the highs, the mid, highs and lows, and use the filter, how to use monitoring so you can listen to songs when they're and not let them come out of the speakers, and then also how to just transition between songs using the channel faders and the crossfader. Other than that, that's kind of the basics. There's more advanced skills you can learn, and you really just talk to the head DJ about learning those. But other than that, that is the basics that you need to know in order to DJ a dance with the Pioneer DDJ WeGo 3.